wanted to get back into in terms of being on the Rise Up October tour, spreading the message of Stop Police Terror, which side are you on? And being in Ferguson 1 year after the murder of Michael Brown. This was very significant because, look, police kill people all the damn time. They kill them with their hands up, they kill them when they're unarmed and innocent. That wasn't the different thing about the murder of Michael Brown. What was different was the young people in Ferguson said, this is it, we have had it. They stood up, they went to the street. The police came with tear gas, rubber bullets, armored personnel carriers. They declared a state of emergency, put down a curfew, activated the National Guard, all in an attempt to tell people, no, you have to take what we do to you. You cannot rise up. You can't stand against it. And the youth of Ferguson said, bullshit. And they were in the streets every night. Last summer, into the fall, into the winter. I know this because I went there in August and stood with them, and then I came back in October and stood with them. This was very significant, sisters and brothers. And 1 year later, people went back to the streets. And it was both the youth from the neighborhood who went back, even though they had been told, don't come back, don't do this, the police declared a special state of emergency, not the police actually. Whoever runs the county issued a special state of emergency, which then the governor of the state of Missouri did. Here's why I call it a special state of emergency. It was a state of emergency which applied to people who wanted to protest police murder. It didn't apply to you if you were with police murder. No, this is real. Because people were told they couldn't march, they got surrounded by police when they tried to rally, they got maced and pepper sprayed, they got rubber bullets shot at them. That's what you got if you tried to protest. However, if you was with what the police was doing, like these oath keepers, during this state of emergency, you could stroll into the area with your rifle, with your shotgun, walking around, talking with the police, laughing and joking with them, like you was their buddies, which we later found out some of them was their buddies. Because one of the oath keepers was out at night as an oath keeper, but his day job was the head of the police in a neighboring city to Ferguson.
I want to go down there.
So some of them was buddies with the police. That's what they tried to do, but they, again, could not stop the youth. But it wasn't just the youth. There were two concerts held that weekend. I mean, they did like Ferguson Rocks, which was a rock concert, and then they did a hip-hop concert 2 days. Brought some really significant artists. I'm gonna try to remember them. Somebody might wanna help me out if I forget too many of them. But Tom Morello from Rage Against the Machine was out there. Boots Riley from The Coup was out there. Immortal Technique, Hometown Boy was out there. The rock band Outer National was out there. Some of them are actually in the house today. They trying to go low key, but I'm out. They hiding over there. Then in the hip hop concert, Talib Kweli, who actually pulled these concerts together, was there. So was Common. So was M1 from Dead Prez.
Yeah.
Immortal Technique performed again. And I may be forgetting some people because I didn't get to that one till late. Then the next day, Monday, some ministers, you know, like Christian preachers, Jewish rabbis, maybe a few Muslim imams was in there too, led a march up to the federal building. The cops had thrown up barricades around the federal building to keep people from getting to it. Didn't work. You had these religious people and also some non-religious people like myself climbing over that barricade, pushing through the police line, going to the federal building, and shutting it down. About 60 people got arrested, including me, by the way, including Cornel West and some others, got busted for that. They also started busting people who were recording it and documenting it. I don't know if any of y'all know D-Ray and Netta, who were two of the people who really have done a whole lot to document the Ferguson uprising. Well, they were documenting it and they got arrested for taking pictures and recording video. And then they busted the live stream. That's how the cops didn't want the story to get out, but it got out anyway. And then as we were getting out of jail after our lockup, we heard that the Interstate 70, which runs through St. Louis, was being blocked by some other people. You know, so everybody was coming out, everybody was standing up. And this is important, because here's the second thing. The killings have continued. You all know that. Just some recent ones, Sandra Bland, sister who had just got her dream job in Texas. The cops stop her for bullshit, and then they don't like her attitude. She don't know her place. So they arrest her, beat her down, throw her into jail, and then a couple days later, she is found dead. Hung. Now they want us to believe she hung herself. I ain't ready to buy that one, especially since the sister is 6 feet tall, and the thing that she was hung from was 5 feet high. So she kind of had to go over like that to hang herself. I ain't real sure about that. Sam Dubose, gunned down by a cop in Cincinnati.